Peace begins with smile. When things are difficult, smile by faith. Good morning and warm welcome to my dear students to the part 2 of second PUC's essay written by Vandana Shiva. Everything I need to know I learned in the forest. When nature is a teacher, we co-create with her. What do you mean by nature is a teacher? Yes, we have to consider nature as our own teacher. And we human beings must work along with nature to recognize her rights. The rights of nature on global stage. In April 2011, United Nations General Assembly, inspired by Ecuador and Universal Declaration of the Rights of the Mother Earth, formulated that a rule that Earth have its own right, and every year, 22nd April, we celebrate Earth Day in order to acknowledge and reaffirm that the Mother Earth got its own right. Now you can see that natural disaster, it is because of one person or one family, that is human beings. Human beings consider Earth as a puppet, or you can tell that human beings take control over the earth, just like men over women, rich over poor, and strong over weak people. Here, human beings consider Mother Earth as or inferior to her, or using the resources as per his whims and fancies. So rights of nature reminds us that we human beings must have a partnership, not a dominion over the earth. Then the situation can be changed. So instead of dominion over earth, we must have a good relationship, that is a partnership relationship. The UN Secretary General report says that harmony with nature. What do you mean by harmony? Going along with nature. And we have to reconnect our relationship with nature, just like the olden time. And if we are going in harmony with nature, everything will be fine with us. And here, you can see a new term, separatism. That is a disharmony. When you separate yourself from nature, there occur a disharmony with nature. Instead of harmony with nature, we are having a disharmony. What is the cause of disharmony with nature? Because you are cutting your relationship, or you are separating your relationship with nature. That create what? Disharmony with nature. The South African environmentalist Cormac Lennon points out that the discrimination, that is apartheid, means discrimination or separateness, is the main root cause. And here you can see a new word, anti-apartheid movement to end the violent separation of people on the basis of color. So apartheid movement, you know that, led by the famous American leader Nelson Mandela. The racial discrimination, here he points out that discrimination against the nature, or we are separating ourselves from the nature, that create a disharmony with nature. Apartheid means what? Discrimination. So here you can see that we need to overcome this eco-apartheid. Eco-apartheid means what? Discrimination against nature. Apartheid means discrimination, the racial discrimination. So here new word is that eco-apartheid means discrimination against nature. That is, the separateness of human from nature in our minds and life must be changed. The word joined in the anti-apartheid movement to end the violent separation of people on the basis of color. The entire human society rejoined the hand against the racial discrimination. And now entire family will live as one family, no color or racial discrimination. So here Vandana Shiva points out that we also must overcome or join hands together against this anti-apartheid movement, against eco-apartheid movement. That is, we mustn't separate ourselves or our life with nature. We need to overcome the deeper apartheid and eco-apartheid based on illusion, the separateness of human being from nature. So here eco-apartheid means separateness of human from nature, and we must have a what relationship? A partnership relationship. The death earth world view. The war against earth, when it began, when we have the idea of separating ourselves with nature. Its contemporary seeds are sown when the living earth was transformed into dead matter, especially during the Industrial Revolution time, where earth, the resources of earth, we treated it just like as a raw material. Raw material, when we consider the Mother Earth only as a means of raw material, what happened? The earth became a dead matter. And then one markers, you have to see the new word. Terra nullius means the empty land, ready for occupation regardless for the presence of indigenous people, replaced by Terra Madre, Mother Earth. Now, after the Industrial Revolution, the situation have changed. We consider the earth just for our raw material sake. It has to be changed to what? As Terra Madre. Instead of Terra Nullius, it must be Terra Madre. Earth mustn't be a empty land. We must consider earth as our mother. The philosopher, you can see the father of English essay, Francis Bacon. The father called the father of modern science. Francis Bacon is also called as the father of modern science. He said that that science and invention that result not merely external a gentle guidance over nature's course. They have power to conquer and subdue her, to shake her to the foundation. Well, according to Bacon, Francis Bacon, the modern, the father of modern science, he explains that scientific inventions are really good, but this invention have the power to shake the earth to her foundation. So we have to be careful when we do our scientific invention, because it may cause harm for our Mother Earth. A philosopher and historian, Caroline Merchant, points out a shift of perspective. Perspective means your outlook. Now we have to consider that nature as a living, nurturing mother instead of dead and manipulable matter. So instead of considering nature as a manipulable or dead matter, we have to consider the earth as a living living thing or a nature as a living, nurturing mother. That led to capitalism. So industrialism, capitalism have destroyed the earth drastically. And there occurred a shift after the industrial revolution and capitalism. We started considering earth as a source to get our raw materials. No, she says that our perspective, our outlook must be changed as earth as a living, nurturing mother, not as a dead matter. The dominion images created by Bacon and other leaders of scientific revolution replace those of nurturing earth. So even the scientists are supporting the views, telling that we have to nurture the mother earth. Nurture means look after or take care, removing the cultural constraint on the exploitation of nature. One does not readily slay the mother, dig into entrails. Entrails means person or animals where internal organs are removed in order to mutilate her body. So what do you mean by this line? Here you are, for the sake of money, you are not ready to cut and sell your mother. Just imagine this earth as your own mother. For the sake of money, the part of your mother's body, the eye, the kidney, are you ready to sell it for the sake of money? No. In that case, you cannot destroy the mother earth for the sake of money. Mutilate her body, cut into pieces for the sake of money. What nature teaches? Today, at the time of multiple crises because of globalization, there must be a paradigm shift of nature as dead matter. Paradigm means a pattern or a model. We need to move an ecological paradigm. Understood? So we must keep earth as a model. For this, the best teacher is nature itself. So in order to how to manage the crisis or how to maintain the balance, from where we can learn, we have to go back to nature itself. She is the best teacher. The Earth University teaches Earth democracy. Means Earth democracy means what? Freedom for everybody. It is for all species within the web of life. And you are here. Freedom means what? Responsibility of human being as a member of the earth to recognize, protect, respect the rights of other species. We speak about democracy for the people, by the people. The same way, earth democracy means freedom for all the species. As a human being, it is our responsibility to recognize, protect and respect the rights of other species. And earth democracy teaches a shift from anthropocentrism. Anthropocentrism means human beings as the center, to ecocentrism means nature as the center. So earth democracy teaches the responsibility to the human beings to protect and respect the rights of nature. And the main key point is that instead of anthropocentrism, we must change our belief or system to ecocentrism. Earth democracy translates human rights to food and water, to free from hunger and thirst. What else we need? We need food. The three basic things what you need is food, water and shelter. So if you wanted to solve the hunger problem, what we have to do is we have to keep earth as the center. The Earth University teaches earth democracy. Democracy means freedom for everybody, not only for human beings, for all the species. Understood? So because of the Earth University is located at Navadanya, a biodiversity farm. The participants in the biodiversity farm, the participants, the people learn how to learn to work with living seed, living soil and the web of life. And the participants are farmers, school children, people from the world. And two most popular courses here in Navadanya they teach is A to Z of organic farming and agroecology and Gandhi and globalization. So in Navadanya, so where is Earth University located? In Navadanya. So what university teaches? The biodiversity farm. Who are the participants? School children, farmers and people across the world. And what are the courses? Just like in your, for your PUC courses, you have science, commerce, art stream. The same way, what are the courses in Navadanya? A to Z of organic farming, agroecology, Gandhi and globalization. The poetry of the forest. The next topic is poetry of the forest. The Earth University, the idea of Earth University has been inspired by Rabindranath Tagore, India's national poet and Nobel laureate. Tagore started a learning center in Shantiniketan in West Bengal. These are for one markers. From where the Earth University is inspired by Tagore. Who is Tagore? India's national poet and Nobel laureate. And Tagore started a learning center in which place? Shantiniketan. As a forest school, both to take inspiration from nature to create Indian cultural renaissance. Renaissance means rebirth. So here in Shantiniketan is what nature-centered learning, where you are getting inspiration from nature itself. The school became a university in which year? In 1921. And what is the main aim? To create Indian cultural renaissance, growing into one of India's most famous centers of learning. So in 1921, Shantiniketan became a university. Today, just in Tagore's time, we have to turn to nature and the forest from the lessons in freedom. If you want freedom, from where you have to learn, you have to go back to nature. In his essay, Tapovan means forest of purity. One marker. Tapovan means forest of purity. Indian civilization has been distinctive in locating its source of regeneration. So, according to Tagore, Indians are known for its intellectual ability, and he says that India's best creativity or intellectual ability have occurred or turned up not in the cities, but the most of the ideas we got when man was communion with trees, rivers, lakes and when he was away from the crowd. The peace of the forest has helped. The Shantiniketan, the board of learning. The peace of the forest have taught us what intellectual evolution of man. That's very important. The peace and serenity of the forest helped us to have intellectual evolution, the change of intellectual. So according to Tagore, the man's best ideas developed when he was in communion with forest. The culture of the forest has fueled the culture of Indian society. One marker. According to Tagore, the culture, the Indian rich, the divergent culture fueled increase or has come out when we were in harmony with nature. And you can say that intellectual part, the forests have played an important role. From season to season, species to species, sight and sound and smell. The unifying principle of life in diversity, democratic pluralism, this became the principle of Indian civilization. One mark. What became the principle of Indian civilization? What became the principle of Indian civilization? The unifying principle are life in diversity, democratic pluralism became the principle. Unifying principle of life in diversity and democratic pluralism. It is in this unity in diversity that is basis of both ecological sustainability and democracy. What do you mean by sustainability? To sustain, ability to maintain the democracy, to maintain the balance of nature. Diversity without unity become a source of conflict and contest. So if you don't have unity, what happens? There will be a fight between among you. Unity without diversity becomes of ground for external control. This is true for both nature and culture. If you are not going to get along with the nature, or if you are not going to have a partnership relationship with nature, what happens? You definitely, there will be a conflict, there will be a war. So we have to be united with nature through our relationship with forest. If you don't want a war or a fight against nature, you must have a good relationship. It is the unity in diversity that is the basis of both ecological sustainability and democracy. So I told you that sustainability, in order to maintain the balance of nature and democracy. Democracy means freedom for all the species. And diversity without unity becomes what? Conflict. And if there is unity without diversity, it became ground for external control. We are using the force. So we have to have a good relationship with forest, united with nature. So all this problem or conflict can be solved if you are united with nature. In Tagore's writing, the forest was not just a source of knowledge and freedom, it was a source of beauty and joy. As mentioned in the earlier paragraph, according to Tagore, the India's best intellectual thought developed when human being was in harmony with nature. And he's adding to that, a forest was also a source of beauty and joy, art and aesthetics, harmony and perfection. Not only the intellectual development, for aesthetic sense, for the creativity, for story writing and harmony and perfection. It is symbolized in the universe. From the nature, we got the ideas. So forest teaches us union and compassion. Not only the intellectual idea, forest teaches what? Union and compassion. The forest also teaches us enoughness as a principle of equity, how to enjoy the gift of nature. These are the very key important points you have to remember. That is, it teaches union and compassion, principle of equity, and to enjoy the gift of nature without exploitation and accumulation. What do we want? We have to keep, not accumulate for the future of us. Because it is not only you are living in the earth, you have to share this earth, because it is a common home for everyone. Tagore quotes from the text that known all that moves in the moving world as enveloped by God, and find enjoyment through renunciation, not through greed and possession. So since this is earth is our common home, we have to share our things. You can take your needs, meet your needs, but not your greed. And you have to renunciation. You mustn't have more attachment with anything. What you need, you possess. And he is telling, the text says that the earth have enough things, not for your greed, but for your need. No species in forest appropriate to share other species. So you can take what you want and share your common home, the earth, with other people, with cooperation. The end of consumerism and accumulation is the beginning of joy of living. Instead of considering earth as a consumer or instead of taking earth as considering earth as a not as a material to meet your needs, but as your mother, and not to accumulate things, then what happens? You will enjoy your life. The conflict between greed and compassion, conquest and cooperation, violence and harmony that Tagore wrote about continues today. And it is in the forest that we can show us the way beyond this conflict. So greed must be changed to compassion, conquest to cooperation, violence to harmony. And if we change our ideas and if we are ready to accommodate our deeds as partnership deed with earth, the earth will be a better place to live in. We are neither going to have future where woman led the way to make peace with earth, or we are not going to have a human future at all. Democracy is not the right to go and buy what you want. It is a responsibility to be accountable to everyone around us. The quote, famous quote from Vandana Shiva. And summing up the writers, Cromaculinan, Caroline Merchant, Rabindranath Tagore, Francis Bacon, Vandana Shiva. So you have to remember these five famous writers, the scientists who have contributed their views and ideas for the growth of our protection of our Mother Earth. So once again, I am reminding you about the last four key points to be, you have to know, that is the forest, the conflict between the greed and compassion, conquest and cooperation, violence and harmony. Everything you can learn from the Mother Nature itself. And we must have a good relationship. What is the relationship? A partnership, well, relationship. Instead of having dominion over earth, we must be ready to share our Mother Earth with everyone. And consider the earth as your own mother. Nurture your Mother Earth with love and care. And start spreading the good news of these famous personalities, thinking that we love nature and we are having freedom, and not only for the human beings, we are going to share the Mother Earth with other species. Vasudeva Kudumbakam, where we are going to share our common home with everyone in a partnership relationship. Love your Mother Nature and nurture it. All the best for all my students. Have a great day.